This week, major political developments are taking place in both Kenya and Zimbabwe. Zimbabwe's state-run broadcaster says Emmerson Mnangagwa will be sworn in as the country's new president, taking over for longtime leader Robert Mugabe. And in Kenya, the Supreme Court on Monday upheld President Uhuru Kenyatta's re-election in the repeat presidential poll last month, paving the way for his swearing in next week. Well, this brings us to our question of the week, which asks, how should the African Union ensure that social justice will prevail in Africa, given the latest political events in Kenya and Zimbabwe? Well, let's start the conversation with a tweet from West Coast, who writes, the only and possible means to ensure social justice in Africa is that the AU should stop taking orders from France. It should be solely independent in its decision and take quick actions during African crises. And we have another tweet from Philip Onen, who says, stop making excuses for corrupt leaders. Remove the option of immunity, which absolves them of consequences for self-seeking governance, and hold them accountable. Be brave to sanctioning its errant peers. Well, now to our social media comment of the week from Facebook fan Wamala Philip in Uganda. He says, whatever is happening in Kenya or Zimbabwe is part of the shortcomings of democracy. Presidential transitions in Africa are often expected to be violent because we've made the presidency a big deal. The African Union, being just a block of African countries, can only offer diplomatic solutions like calling for dialogue to avoid being partisan. Well, let's go to another comment from Facebook fan Wycliffe Barasa from Kenya, who writes, the African Union needs to be independent with bias organization. It should not defend crooks and looters. The AU is good at giving written information and ideas, but it is hard for them to implement them. Agenda 2063 of the AU has every solution, but there is no implementation. The AU is still being enslaved by the European Union, United Nations, United States, and other Western organizations. And our last Facebook comment comes from Andrew Mwiba of Zambia, who writes, the AU should be proactive and not reactive. Right now, there are some leaders in Africa who are students of Mugabe and Museveni. What is the AU doing now to make sure we do not have such situations like Zimbabwe or Kenya? Election observing by AU is not genuine at all. Well, a reminder that we appreciate all of the audience feedback. If you're a new fan, drop us a line at africatv@voanews.com. To comment on our Facebook page, just enter the keywords Straight Talk Africa. Be sure to visit us online at voaafrica.com. To join our YouTube channel, sign up to VOA TV to Africa. Follow us on Twitter at VOA Shaka. Straight Talk Africa streams live every Wednesday on Facebook, or simply go to VOA Straight Talk Africa TV program page on our website. To watch us live on your mobile device, just download the VOA mobile app.